Hello viewers, it is my esteemed pleasure to welcome you back to our YouTube tutorial videos. In this tutorial video, I'm going to take you through a detailed and a comprehensive process where we'll be creating a title block for our project and also to look at how we are going to make use of the masters, make use of the different layouts, and also how to customize our title block to our own taste and preference. So before we proceed, I would like you to subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you may not miss our future tutorial videos that we'll be putting up in this place for your consumption and also for the growth of this profession. So to begin, this is my design that I would wish to have title blocks drawn on it, because you realize that for the title block, it is the most significant part of our designs that enables the designer to give specific details about what the design is all about, and even the specifics about the client, and even the design details and other aesthetic information such as the scales and other different features. So to begin this particular process, I'll first identify the navigator panel, which is located on the right hand side of this screen. And in case you don't see it, you'll be able just to look at the new tab, and you'll click on it and it will be able to appear. You can also look at it on the bottommost part of the page, which is always located at the left hand side of the screen. So my first assignment is to have a masters, and for me, a masters ensures that you are able to have a kind of a template where the rest of the title blocks will be drawn, since it is acting as the trace reference for this particular session. So in this case, I'll first identify one of the masters that will be ideal to this design. And for me, I'll take an A1 landscape. Of course, I need an A1 because it is large enough, it is sizable, and it will be able to accommodate most of the drawings, I mean, even the designs that I'll be putting up in this place. So the first thing, I'll click on the landscape, and I'll ensure that there's a blank space that is just coming from this particular page. And on the right hand corner of this page, you'll be able to see a template of this title block that is established. So the next thing for me will be to ensure that I'm able to customize, I'm able to even make some particular settings so that this particular design is customized to our own taste. So in this case, I'll be able to improve on this blank page by putting some settings in place. So I'll click on the bottommost part of that page, and a title block, a dialog box will be appearing on the screen where I'll be able to specify the kind of project that I want to have in this case. So for me, I'll name that as an architectural master layout. Since I had selected A1, I will leave it at that because it is fairly large. I'll maintain the landscape portrait, of course, for it to accommodate all the design features that I have. Then when it comes to margin, I'll be able to leave a reasonable margin so that it doesn't eat up into the space that I've left for my design. So in that case, I'll be able to maybe scale down that a bit and have it as 8 millimeters. that is from the top to the bottom. I'll also have the bottom to top as 8. Then on the left side, I'll maintain it as 14, of course, because I need some fairly large space to enable me accommodate those designs. And then on the right-hand side, I will need a fairly small space for the title block. So the printable area will be that, which is a bit reasonable. Then the design master layout for this panel will be below the layout. And then I will click OK once everything is set to my preference. The next thing that I'll do here is to ensure that I have given details of the all these particular deliverables that are required of me. So for me, how to accomplish that is that I will come to the project that I've named, then I will click on it. I'll click on it, or rather I'll right click on it, sorry. Then once I right click on it, I will see the information that is coming out here, and I'll select on the project info that will give me the relevant items to add. So probably we look at the project details. That is everything that is required there. The project name, I've named that as that. You can change that according to your taste. The project description is also how you wish to be. Then the project ID, you'll give it a unique character. Same to the project code and even the project number. Project status, you can have it as either proposed, renovations, or finished, or any other word that you wish to have. Then you can also have the site details of that particular project, where it is located, and then even the building materials, you can also add them according to the relevant information that you have particular to that specific design. Others like contact details, you can also add. You can have the contact details, the for the client, the role, and even the particular department. You can also have the who's the designer, the CAD technician, contact companies, and all other relevant information that we wish to add for this particular design. So having put all that into consideration and having put them in place, you can now click OK, and all those settings and even the changes that you had aspired to make will be put in that particular change. So once that is complete, then we have a master for our title block, and it is the one that will be used as a trace reference for this particular project. So my next task in this case is now to go to the layout, because it is this particular layout that all the relevant information that we have put in our masters will be able to be displayed at the layout. So for me to create new layouts, the first thing that I'll do is to locate the new layout tab, which is here. So what I'll do is I'll just click on it, and there's a dialog box that will be appearing. So once the dialog box appears, I'll be able to give it a name, or rather assign it a layout name. So in that case, I will be able to have the layout name as ground floor. Ground floor, that is okay. Then I will put this ground floor as let me put it as a master layout. Then of course it's that is the A1. Then I will draw my ID prefix as A, of course, to ensure to make to enable me name them appropriately. Then I will click on create, and that is what will come. So as you can see, is that we now have a landscape size, and it also A1 according to how we wanted it. You can also verify that this is particularly traced from the master layout. As you can see, all the information that was on the master layout is also appearing on the ground floor layout plan, and that is able to, you can also be able to see that the margin is particularly given according to how we had purposed it to be. So my next assignment is to create another layout, another new layout for that, another new layout. So I'll just go back to that, and then for this one now I will name it as elevations to cater for the various elevations that we had put in place. Then I will also have that as A, and then I will simply say create, and you'll be able to see another layout just coming out from that. So we now have a ground floor, we now have elevations just to cater for our design needs. Now the next thing that we'll have is to ensure that we are able to profile the project designs based on the relevant places that they need to be. What I simply mean is we are going to navigate through the various designs and then place them to their relevant layout plans. So for me to accomplish that, I will go to the project chooser. I will click on that. Then I will select the show organizer. So for show organizer, I'll be able to have this particular dialog box that is featuring a layout editor that will enable me to merge whatever we have for the ground floor to the relevant layout plan for that particular one. So for me here, I'll first identify where my ground floor is. Of course, that is the first layout plan that I'll be working with. So I'll locate it where the floor plan is. Then I will have the ground floor there. Then what I will do is I will click on it and then hold on to the mouse and then simply transfer it to where the ground floor is. And I really need you to be cautious because you need to ensure that you are placing it right where the ground floor is. So to enable you accomplish that, there are particular arrows, like you can see that we have a red arrow here. So that will mean that you're not supposed to drop it there. And same to the black one, which is also supposed to show that you are not supposed to drop your ground floor plan from there. So once this is in place, you'll see that there are no either red or black lines. So you can simply just drop your plan there, and you give it a few minutes as it is able to update. And then once that is in position, you will see that the ground floor will have that particular floor plan in place. Then the next thing that we'll do there is to see whether that floor plan has appeared on the layout plan as it was intimated. So I'll look at my floor plan here. As you can see, it has come out of the floor plan, but in an ambiguous way. So what I can simply do is just to bring it to the right position inside that layout plan. Okay, remember I can still position it well so that it is in line with our layout plan. So I can still do some, can take it still up, and as you can see now, our choice for Our choice for the A1 size is in order because we are now able to accommodate all the relevant design features that we had in our floor plan. So I believe you can be able to see that has worked well. Then my next assignment is to now work on the elevations. That is now the ground floor. So I'll still go back to my project navigator. I'll click on the show organizer. Once I've clicked on the show organizer, I'll be able to find the elevations and then match them with the layout book. So I will start with the east elevation. Of course, I'll start with the east elevation. Once I've located the east elevation, I will drag it slowly up to where elevations are. You need to ignore the black line and even the red one. So once you don't see the black line there, you can just simply just drop it like that. Then wait for it to be updated. That is okay. Then you'll close that tab and check on the elevations. You can see that the elevation, the east elevation has just come there, so you can just drag it nicely on that particular window. So I'll still find a means of dragging it up to that position, and then I can even enlarge it a bit, that it is a bit more sizable. I think that is okay. Yeah, that is nice. So you can be able to see that now this is something that we had worked on well, and it is also coming out pretty well based on the design. So let's just do some enlargements so that it can cover the entire area. Let me leave it at that. That is now nice. So that is the east elevation, and I can simply do this for all the elevations that are present for that. Let me have a next one. Can have a next one here. Show organizer. Of course, what I need to do first is to create another layout. Can create another layout. Can have another layout. Can still name that as elevations. Ensure that it is the architectural master layout. Have it as A, and then I'll create. Once that is done, I go to the project chooser, show organizer. Then I'll locate the elevations. This time round, I think I can select on the north elevation and drag it. I can drag it. Yes. So drag that, can close it. Then what I'll do can cut that and then have it here. Paste. Paste. Still updating. That is now the That is now what we call the north elevation. Just as we did the last one, we can increase the size. Let's increase the size. Let's increase the size. Make sure that it is occupying. It's occupying the. Yeah. I think that is okay. North elevation. So I believe that is well elaborate, and that is how we can be able to ensure that we create these title blocks according to the preferred tests and preferences that you as a designer have for that particular case. So I believe that is well elaborate, and I think these features will be able to guide you even to make other necessary adjustments, and to also ensure that you are able to come to terms with the customization of title blocks based on the way you want it and based on the standard ways of doing it. I've come to the end of this tutorial video, and please, if you're not subscribed to it, kindly do so, and watch out for more of our videos as we'll be putting up in this platform, so that we can be able to learn and share more ideas. Feel free to comment, like, and even share, so that we can grow together in this. For now, thank you and have a good day.